The next speaker is TKS Elangovan.
Thank you, Honorable Vice Chairman, sir. This bill, as was stated by my colleagues earlier, is in violation of the constitutional provisions, Article 252. If the government wanted a bill of this kind to be brought in, they should have sought. The Constitution says two or more states by consent of the states. This government has not taken the consent of the states. The question is not about dam safety. The question now we raise is about the safety or the powers of the state being infringed. That is the only question. Sir, Tamil Nadu, in India, the first ever dam, the idea of storing of water during rainy season and using it subsequently for irrigation, the first dam was built before 1,000 years, called 2,000 years, Grand Anaket Kallanai, which is still strong, and we are using it. So construction of a dam is not new to Tamil Nadu, and we know how to do it. My friend, Mr. Alphonse, was very considerate in giving water. But one thing what he said is a clue, that he said, okay, if the dam is not safe, Kerala will build a dam, not the central government or not under the supervision of the central government. It is between these two states to decide whether the dam is strong or not, or weak. And they are all our friends. They were all part of the old Madras presidency when the dam was built. So they are not our enemies. The only question is, nowadays, Tamil Nadu is more dependent on water from the neighboring states. Tamil Nadu, the delta area, is the richest crop area in Tamil Nadu. But we are dependent on the other states only because after independence, these states were made linguistic states. Otherwise, these dams were built by us, by the Madras Presidency. The water agreement was between the Madras Presidency and the Mysore Maharaja. The water agreement with Mullai Periyar is between Madras Presidency and the Travancore Maharaja. So, what my question is, we want our Kerala friends to be, people to be safe. We are not against that. That is why we wanted the central government, Supreme Court's intervention, and Supreme Court inspected the dam and said that it is strong. It is the Supreme Court's order. Even if somebody finds that the dam is not strong even now, it is a duty of the state to repair it, because the owner of the dam is the state. The bill also mentions about it. It is the responsibility of the owner to rectify whatever problem that exists in the dam or any construction, in the, not only dam, sir. Sir, they are talking about dams. There are many buildings built by the state government. Whether the government of India will come forward and say that any construction, we will bring in a legislation to study the strength of the construction, because even one building falls, at least two people will die. So they are not for the people. Our fear is that we have faced many problems. Tamil Nadu had faced many problems in the sharing of water. Every time we had to approach the court of law. The first question was that whether an agreement can, after 50 years, whether the agreement still is in life or not. Sir, the world over, the lower ripe Indian rivers were never stopped from using the rainwater. You know, the longest river in the world is Nile. It starts from Egypt. It goes up to the near South Africa. But no state in between uses that, because there is a due share of water in the Nile, but we have certain problems. We have faced certain problems. We have to go to court. The central government did not come to our support. Now you are bothered about dams. If you are really want the people of the states to survive and live in peace, you should be bothered about water, not dams. Dams we will take care. We are the owners of that construction. We will take care. But the government of India should be bothered about water and proper distribution of water to all states. Safety is our concern. It is our, we are the owners of the dam. The states are the owners of the dam. It is our concern. Secondly, if you had wanted, as per Article 252, if you are really interested in bringing a legislation like that, you should have followed Article 252 and got the consent of all these states in the country. Why you are not respecting state governments? Our worry is that Schedule 7, the state list, is becoming smaller and smaller, and most of the rights, right from education, is being taken away by the union government. Why should we leave? Then why are we states? What? We are also elected by the people. We know how to run the state. People have faith in us and elect us to rule the state. But ultimately, the powers are being taken away by the center, which is, it is against the constitution. So there are certain legal issues in this bill, may go to the court of law. So please send the bill to the select committee and let the select committee decide on these bills. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Ms. Alan Gowan.